Our viewer question today is about a TVP, or textured vegetable protein. And they have asked, it seems like textured vegetable protein is a healthy way to get protein, but they've also heard some negative things and people say that it's not so good for you. So they'd like to know what your take on it is.
Texturized vegetable protein is interesting stuff. It was invented in 1960, I think, by Archer Daniels Midland Corporation. I think they still hold the patent on it. And I've read, like this viewer has, pluses and minuses about it. And the minuses, by and large, are one, it's a highly processed food. You make this by taking essentially soybeans, you extract the oil out of it, you're left with soybean flour that they cook with under high temperature and high pressure, and it turns into a paste. They put it out through an extruder, and as the mixture, this pasty mixture, comes through the little holes in the extruder, as soon as it hits the room temperature air at lower pressure, it cools off and puffs up. And this is what is sold as a texturized vegetable protein. And it's got a meaty-like texture to it, and it can be flavored to give it a slightly salty taste. And it's very useful, and it's used in vegan spaghetti sauces and burgers and places where you use ground beef or ground chicken or turkey. Texturized vegetable protein is a stand-in. And on the positive side, it's high in protein. And again, for someone who's really short on nutrition, someone with poor dentition, they can't eat a lot of vegetables, etc. Although if you cook beans until they're nice and soft, you'll get plenty of legume protein that way. But I could see that there's people who could benefit from the concentrated protein source. But it's a novelty food. It's there for mostly for your taste and texture enjoyment. And the only real negative outside of it being highly processed and chemicals are used to create it is whether it has monosodium glutamate, MSG, in the production of the hydrolyzing the soy protein, you create monosodium glutamate. One, I think MSG is not recognized as being such an evil molecule any longer, and the amount of MSG in texturized vegetable protein is very small. And you don't eat, if you want to be eating this stuff just a little bit once or twice a week, I don't think that's a great negative not to use it. So by and large, on the positive negative side, I come down on the positive side of TVP, but it's a treat food, it's a processed food. It's like these veggie burgers, they're a treat. Have some once a week, once a month, and you ought to be fine. So I'm glad the stuff exists. It helps as a transition food for Joe meat and potatoes guy to taste a spaghetti sauce or a pizza topping that has TVP in it, texturized vegetable protein, and he said, oh, that tastes pretty good. That was chewy and salty, and wow, tasted just like meat. And he's happy as that as a substitution. Then I'm all for it, and it's performed a really great service. But for the established vegans, it's not a whole food. Whole foods are where it's at. So view it as a treat, but it's one of the more beneficial processed foods that I think has a small place in a healthy diet. Hi, everyone. Dr. Michael Klaper here, announcing our new format for our Q&A with Dr. K. Each day, Andy Hagen will be asking me one question that's been sent in by our viewers. So if you want to see if your question is getting answered, do join us for our daily Q&A with Dr. K right here. Hope to see you then.